Ding, ding, ding.
Ding, ding, ding.
Ding, ding, ding.
To the M to the C.
He's known as OMC, a tongue-in-cheek name meaning Ōtara Millionaires Club.
Oh man, how bizarre.
You know it's a hit when it's the only song from your country that your parents listen to.
I'm so proud of the bro, fuck.
You can't deny the swag, it's just like, ooh.
People always say, oh, why don't you sing it for us? And oh, yeah. You probably know the words better than me, you know?
Brother Bellas in the back, sweet singers in the front. Cruising down the freeway in the hot, hot sun.
Pauly Fuemana.
Kirstine Fuemana. I was married or with Paul for 16 years from the very early 90s through to his death in 2010. The first probably big single was O to the M to the C.
We are the O to the M to the C.
Millionaires Club.
When I first heard Paulie's voice, I thought, wow, that's something special going on there.
Because of his cadence and his flow was incredible.
It's almost like he was rapping through a trumpet.
That to me was a big joke, but I just thought, oh well, you know, if one guy really believes in me, then I'll give it a go.
He said to me, do you think I've got what it takes? I said, yeah, I think you've got a unique creation. The world loves it and you need to give them more.
This is one character that was just crazy creative.
Yeah, he just had this love of words and love of all music. He wrote endlessly, like I have books and books at home of pages of words.
His mindset was just way bigger. He kind of like foresaw that there was more to it.
Then a friend of mine offered us the gig at the big day out, and Pauly didn't have any songs whatsoever. And we sat down the night before we had to fly out, and we wrote 8 songs. We were up till sort of 6 in the morning. How bizarre was one of those songs? He had the chorus part, every time I look around.
Every time I look around.
It wasn't good, how bizarre, it was called Dufra. I said to him, you meant such a sight. Every time I look around, this stuff it up. I said, oh, that's really bizarre. And I thought, how bizarre? You know, so it's how bizarre.
He said, my dad used to play this to me, and he played.
Ding, ding, ding.
He played it on a $15 guitar that I found in a junk shop.
How bizarre. How bizarre. How bizarre.
How Bizarre is like this perfect mix of rap and pop melody, I suppose.
It definitely went more a poppy route.
You know, for me, it wasn't a dope hip-hop song.
When I first heard How Bizarre, I hated it.
But it was that format that most people like.
So when it took off, I was probably more surprised than anybody.
How Bizarre come on TV, that's when we were like, whoa, he did it. Like, I know him.
Massive. You sound like a Mexican.
Suddenly red blue lights.
You look like a Mexican.
Loud voice booming.
The Mexicans are gonna love this song.
A Chevy 69.
And they did.
How bizarre.
I got me to LA and it was coming out of every second shop.
It's in my face.
Kiwi singing sensation Pauly Fuemana has made pop history.
People jump and jive and the clowns are stuck around.
Can you believe it? Like you're wanting to pinch yourself?
Yeah, it hasn't hit me yet. I mean, everyone's sort of, oh, you've got to do it, you've got the number one, but it hasn't hit me yet.
All of a sudden, he's invited to all the big tosser gigs like me.
I mean, I'm from Ōtara. I mean, I say that. I mean, like, it's really hard to be in a point where you're actually surrounded by some really famous people and you don't know what to say. And you're awkward and, you know, you knock over glasses of wine and stuff and people don't understand that, eh?
But you're probably one of them now.
I don't think so.
You'd be getting recognised around the place though, wouldn't you?
I don't think my mum would think that.
Because we didn't have the internet back then, he literally would have to get on a plane to do any promo.
He was just busy, busy, busy the whole time.
We got a call to say he had to go to London to do Top of the Pops.
And this song is the biggest song in the history of New Zealand music.
We were absolutely like shocked that he was on a flight that morning.
OMC! Suddenly red blue light flashes from behind.
I was at work when he arrived back in town, and then he said, I've got to get back on a flight tonight. I think he'd gone number one by that stage. So he was on a flight within 24 hours. He had done two trips.
Number one in over 13 countries around the world, the highest selling New Zealand single in history.
And do the Americans like the Pacific beat?
I love it. I love it. It's original. I can't even like put the music in a category.
Yeah! Yeah, I saw OMC. Woo!
We got married in 97 and he came home quickly from New York to get married. He flew back out.
I actually went to Portugal and Switzerland, Sweden and Belgium, Germany.
For years, Pauly was out there promoting the same song.
I'm going to Thailand in about a week's time, to the Philippines and it. And Hong Kong, and that's just 4 weeks.
Every time the record company said, look, we need to put a new single out, radio just said to them, we're still playing How Bizarre.
We were like on this ride that I don't think any of us could control. It was so new to us, it was so new to New Zealand.
You know, everybody was laughing because, you know, there's no millionaires in Ōtara, but, you know, there is some millionaires in Ōtara now.
It's crazy some of the shit that he scored, you know?
How much did you make from that song?
About 11 million.
I heard he just bought all these whips, eh? Just bought all these cars.
Didn't he have a Hummer or something like that way back in the day?
Oh, you know, I bought a Hummer. As you do, you know.
Pauly and his brother Tony put on a barbecue for us, and I swear there were like 100 steaks.
And he had a mixing desk in his whatia that was fucking ginormous.
You know, like 100 steaks, and there was just four of us.
We didn't have accountants or lawyers set up for that. We didn't have entertainment lawyers in New Zealand at that stage.
You know, OK, we're a bit bananas, but I mean, funny, yeah.
Even using cameras, there's choppers in the sky. Marines, police, reporters ask where, for and why.
He got quite a lot of shit, quite frankly. He was called a sellout because he didn't push his language, but for him it just wasn't what happened. It didn't mean he didn't love his culture or himself or his people.
They said, oh, you can do better than that. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, right, whatever.
In New Zealand, we don't celebrate ourselves enough, and he can have sold more or done more or whatever, but Paul would still not be held in as such high esteem as someone like Dave Dobbin.
I remember like about a year and a half ago, it was Pauly Fuemana, the one-hit wonder. It's like been like nearly 2 years now.
To me, a one-hit wonder was better than a no-hit wonder.
We still have that song going into films and television, and we get requests for it all the time.
Biggest buzz of my life. I'd always wanted, more than anything, I'd always wanted to have a number one in America.
But it's just one of those unique songs that really came from the heart and soul of Pauly Fuemana.
Happiness is just that. It's the achievement of a goal. Pleasure you can get from a warm bath, but happiness is when you really achieve something, eh?
The singer who shot to fame and fortune with the hit How Bizarre has died.
The 40-year-old's death from pneumonia earlier this week, a shock to the Polynesian music heavyweights who came to mark their respect.
I lost a good friend.
Over 250 friends and family came to celebrate what they described as the first Polynesian to take New Zealand music to the world.
He's not dead in my world. I still fucking think of Pauly often.
You know, rest in peace to the uzo. What a contribution.
Massive memories, cuz. Massive. I don't give a fuck about the song. I still don't know what it's about. But I love the bro.
Man, that he was from Ōtara, he was from the hood. And he just went around the world and smashed it.
I watched him experience things that a kid from Ōtara, who unfortunately had pretty much been on the street since 11, would never imagine they could live. Just to see him grow as a person, and, you know, he screwed up a bit, and, you know, he had made mistakes like any of us would, but to actually achieve and to experience some of the things he did, and I could just see on his face that, you know, he was pretty quietly pleased with what he had done.
There was a good ride right at last, I didn't. I got to see the world. Like, I really got to see the world, you know.
In the back, sweet singers in the front, cruising down the freeway in the hot.